I am peace. I am absolutely free. Peace cannot happen to me. I am peace. I am perfectly free. Peace cannot incomplete me. Okay? And ultimately, we do need to get to this point because the sour grapes people will press this happening to the utmost, and they will back you into a corner and try to make you say, hey, you know, be consistent. They got a gun on you. You know, they got a gun. They got a gun on you. Cosmic corporate culture has got a gun on religious people right now. Okay, believe me when I tell you this. And they're going to try to back you into a corner. So we say, no problem. Okay, I am spirit. I am free. Problems cannot happen to me. And right there, problems cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Level confusion cannot happen to me. I am light. I am free. Level confusion cannot incomplete me. Level confusion cannot incomplete me. So what they try to do is they trap you. And I'm just sharing with you now, how you say there's no trap. I am spirit. I am free. Entrapment cannot happen to me. And what they try to do is say, hey, wait a minute. You know, we're trying to get peace too. We're on the same page. And I say, no, we're not. We're in absolutely opposite pages. And I mean, there's no real similarity to the pages. There's no true compatibility to these pages whatsoever. Because they're saying that strife can happen. Lack of peace can happen to all of us everywhere. But they're finding a way to drive that up, you know, to feed that strife and discord by bringing peace, making peace happen. You know, they say, you know, war can happen, but they say, you know, also peace can happen. And we're not fooled by that at all. We're saying, I am spirit. I am absolutely free. War cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Peace cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. There isn't anything that can happen to me. Okay? This will get you to supernature. Okay? This will get you to supernature. The other saying war can happen to us, but peace can happen to us also. And if we all get on the same page, we can make peace happen. That will keep you stuck in the cycles we call nature. Guaranteed. Okay? So it's very simple. We don't need to defeat anything. There isn't anything that can happen to us. So, I am spirit. I am free. Defeat cannot incomplete me. So what's being shared here is literally the key to supernature. Literally the key to supernature. Seeing this dualistic deception that, yeah, war can happen to me, but yeah, peace can happen to me also, and we can just make peace defeat war, and then we'll help you. That's called duality. This is what nature's deception of, this is how we keep ourselves deceived, and keep entertaining nature. This is how we keep putting nature on our plate, exactly how we do it. And we get free of that by saying, I am spirit. I am free. There isn't anything that can happen to me. No exceptions. I am spirit. I am free. There aren't any exceptions that can happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Exceptions cannot incomplete me. Meaning the exceptions that people keep trying to say, that attitude, meaning the attitude of exceptions, cannot incomplete me. Cannot incomplete me. So in this world, nature, there are sudden thunderstorms of troubles that strike in this world. As we know. Look at that earthquake and tsunami. It was not too long ago, was it not? It was the day after Christmas. Boxing Day, I think they call it in the British, the colonies in the British Commonwealth. Tsunami, earthquake, radioactive, you know, nuclear reactor problem. Boom, right? Just like that. Talk about a freak out. I mean, what have we gone through? What does nature keep throwing at us, right? I mean, we're just getting tortured. Okay, torture here, absolutely tortured. But I am spirit, I am free. Torture cannot happen to me. I am light. I am absolutely free. Torture cannot incomplete me. Meaning any notion, any idea, belief of this, those such beliefs cannot incomplete me in the slightest bit. So I remain absolutely light, which means I am spirit, I am free. Torture can't even happen to me. Torture cannot happen to me. But the people, you know, spirits who are in, still in delusion, dualistic delusion, they're saying, help, God, help, help, all this stuff's happening to me. So much stuff's happening to me. Please send your saints and saviors and pray for me and help. Please send someone that can help me, you know, help me have something better happen to me because all this terrible stuff's happening to me. I don't know what to do. No, no, this is a trick. This is all being staged. They're saying, basically say, hey God, look at everything that's happening to you, God. Look at everything that's happening to you. Why don't you double down on all this and confirm that all this stuff, bad stuff's happening to you by sending your saints to make better stuff happen to me. See, if you do that, then you basically say, oh yeah, all this stuff is happening to you, right? Which means it's happening to God, which means spirit is proving, oh, okay, I am greater than you, God, because you had to stop all this stuff from happening to me. You know? So what God did is say, hey, change your prayers, change your whole perspective here, saying, I am spirit, I am free, flesh cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. There isn't anything whatsoever that can ever, ever, ever happen to me. This is what God tells us. This is what God sent Jesus to tell us. This is how you pray. This is how you pray. Now, there's not a lot of us praying like this, actually, is there? Scant few, and it's getting less all the time. I'm only able to do this because a lifetime of intense effort to try and get to this point and listen to Jesus as I try to understand, what, you know, how do you want me to pray, Jesus, you know? It has taken me a lifetime of effort to get here. So severe is the dualistic, you know, intensity here of people saying you're absolutely nuts if we, you know, you're not helping us. How selfish can you be? You know, what do you mean? How selfish can you be to say that stuff cannot happen to us? Look at everything's happened to everybody and you're not trying to help them out. You should spend your, if you want to be a saint, spend your life doing charity works and helping people out. Otherwise you're just a selfish, crazy person. You know, this is the attitude that drives us into despair here, right? Those who want to bring in right prayer here tend to be collapsed by this sour grain attitude here that just is very, very stormy towards them, you know. But, you know, here we are. Great, here we are, here we are, here we are. I am spirit. I am free. Circumstances cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Situations cannot happen to me. I am light. I am free. There isn't anything that can happen to me. So, you want to help the world? Help everyone, help all spirits? This is how you help them. This is how you help them. Right prayer. Right prayer. Right practice, right practice, right prayer, right practice, right prayer. Now it's basically totally quiet again, right? Wow. Caught on tape, caught on video, wasn't it? It was caught on video. How about that? That's really something. Landmark video, this isn't it? A landmark video. I am spirit. I am free. There isn't anything that can happen to me. Now, if everybody would say, start practicing in this way, welcome to supernature, everyone. We'd all put supernature on our plates, absolutely. And that's what we would be dining upon. We would be dining upon it. I am spirit, I am free. There isn't anything that can happen to me. See the difference between duality and non-duality, singularity, duality, and singularity difference. Duality says, yeah, everything can happen to us, but we can pick and choose what we want to have happen and other stuff not happen to us. That's duality. Singularity says there isn't anything that can happen to us. There isn't anything whatsoever that could ever happen to us because we are absolute freedom. And there isn't anything at all that can happen to absolute freedom. How could there be? And with this, at least this starts sinking in, and you start glimpsing this, then you just start saying, wow, this is legit teaching. You say, wow, this is really legit. This is really legit. I see this. See, absolute freedom, how can anything happen? How can there be something happening to that? Because freedom is instantly experiencing whatever it wants to experience. How can it say something is happening to it? Absolute freedom is the happening, is the only happening there is. There isn't any other happening. It's a singularity of happening. And it's our inherent nature is the happening. Isness is the happening. There is no other happening. There is no other happening. That's singularity. If the duality says, no, there's another happening, all this stuff is happening to us, but can we at least use our powers, spiritual powers, to pick and choose what we want to have happen? This is delusion. This is delusion based on our desire to actually change reality. Based on our desire to change reality to prove that we're greater than God. And God is not mad at us. God loves us. Freedom is still perfect. Okay? How does God love us? Absolute freedom is still absolute freedom. That's how. No change at all. Absolutely none. Because nothing real is threatened, nothing unreal exists. So, we were told there would be this drastic drop in temperature. Yeah, it just happened so quickly. There could very well be a drastic temperature drop in the world in terms of the social climate. And we're going to go into this massive cold war of demand for compliance, you know. This cold war being used as a way to enforce collapse into compliance in some way. Very funny, a couple weeks ago, I was somewhere and there's some Russians working there, and I talked with them and interacted with them a bit. I never talked or interacted with Russians before. And I was like, wow, they're so different than us. And I found them to be very delightful, actually. Their attitude was so different. They were so unaffected. Obviously they came from a different, very different culture. They just had this like lack of defensiveness to them. You know, it's just the kind of lack of self-consciousness. It's just, it's a whole different feel. They came from a very different cultural vibe. I just like, wow, this is amazing. You know, we're told the Russians are these are, you know, real sly KGB wicked, you know, and stuff. But I'm sure there's some of that. There isn't every group of people, you know, but Russian people, who know, we don't even know what they're like. They could be actually rather cool, delightful in a lot of ways, actually. So I'm saying, let us not scapegoat. Let not the world scapegoat the Russians. This is very, very inadvisable. Let the world back away from scapegoating altogether. I am spirit, I am free. Scapegoating cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Scapegoating cannot incomplete me. Cannot incomplete me. Feels that it can finally win the Cold War. Big mistake. Big mistake. Wars are never won. Wars cannot even happen to us. The more we say wars can happen, the more we say we can win wars, the more we believe wars can happen to us. Okay? This is duality. This is the devastation of duality that we need to understand. The more we feel we can defeat evil, the more we believe evil can happen to us. Okay? Whatever we claim evil is, you know, I mean, we set up demons and scapegoats for our own nastiness, really. See, I don't feel, you know, antagonistic to any country in the world or any people in the world. Not even here, U.S., which is a very problematical place in a lot of ways, actually. I live in California with the great, you know, monster Hollywood. Hollywood is just an anathema, and you know, it's like almost shameful to live in California. You live in proximity to Hollywood. Actually, it is shameful, but in a certain, you know, certain way. But I am spirit. I am free. Hollywood cannot happen to me. You see, I am spirit. I am free. Hollywood cannot incomplete me. I am light. I am absolutely free. Hollywood can never incomplete me. Cannot in any way. Hollywood cannot in any way incomplete me. So America's great at pointing out evils in the world. It's very poor at recognizing its own evils, you know. So looking in a mirror. It's very, has a very tough time looking in the mirror, really. And when it does, it tends to disassociate with what it sees and make up something else. You know, it doesn't really spirit, you know, get down to right spiritual practice. It tends to go back into activism. Oh no, yeah, well, evils here are is you know, social injustice, you know. But it doesn't really look, you know, at what, you know, Hollywood, for instance, doesn't really look at capitalism, doesn't really look at all of the stuff that it is promoting, which is promoting cosmic corporate culture, you know, is promoting dualism, is what it's doing. It's the biggest promoter of dualism on the planet, America. No question about it. It doesn't see that, you know. It doesn't look in that mirror, the real mirror of self-reflection, the mirror of the Holy Spirit. Look in the mirror of the Holy Spirit. Does the United States still look in the mirror of the Holy Spirit? It used to, but that was before cosmic corporate culture took it over. As Dwight D. Eisenhower, a true American, said, you know, the real danger in the world is this military-industrial complex taking over this United States and the Western world and the world in general. Yeah. Well, he was talking about cosmic corporate culture, and he knew, Dwight D. Eisenhower knew more than he told us, because he knew about cosmic corporate culture, because he had contact with cosmic corporate culture. And so he was very aware that cosmic corporate culture extends beyond this planet. It's coming from other planets, other dwelling places in this cosmos, who had contact in corporate culture on this planet and formed alliances with them behind the backs of governance entirely. entirely. He knew something was going on, demanded that he be told what's going on. I sent one of his closest aides saying, if you don't tell him what's going on, I'm going to send the divisions, all these divisions, and I'm going to absolutely shut you down. And so he found out about it. And there are stories, other stories about how he found out about other stuff. So when he warned us, and of course Ronald Reagan warned us too, he says the threat from the world is from space. Okay, Ronald Reagan also, another true American, knew about this and warned us. So we have been told, the United States, the people of the world have been told, hey, military-industrial complex is really cosmic corporate culture. This is taking over the country. Well, it's taken over the country, and it's taken over the world. And there are some conflicts arising from that right now that we're seeing. Some people don't exactly like being taken over by that. They may have their own designs to take over the world. Right? But what's important to keep in mind is the spiritual practice here. Recognizing dualism for what it is, okay? Dualism doesn't work. Dualism just reinforces insanity, reinforces problems. The more you say you're defeating problems, the more you're claiming that problems can happen to you. Which is the more you're creating severe continuity fear, the more you're insisting that you're greater than God, the more frightened you are thinking that you've defeated God and changed reality, the more afraid you are to go back to reality thinking that you've decimated it. All of this stuff comes from duality. So, unfortunately, the prayer system of the world is largely erroneous and geared to act to duality. When we petition God, see, what we're saying is, God, all this terrible stuff is happening to us, and we can't do anything about it, except we need your help to defeat it. You know, defeat it. This is just reinforcing that all this stuff can happen to us. We're saying, yes, all this can happen to us, but God is going to ride in with a flaming sword on a white horse and is going to defeat all these happenings. This just makes things worse, okay? So we say, I am spirit. I am free. There isn't anything at all that can happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. There are no troubles that can happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. There are no stories that can happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. There is no bondage that can happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. There are no modifications. Modifications can't happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Disappearance can't happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Purges cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Sanctions cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Penalties cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Bullying cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Duality cannot happen to me. I am light. I am free. Duality cannot incomplete me. I am spirit. I am free. Extinguishment cannot happen to me. I am spirit. I am free. Advertising cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Pricing cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Creeds cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Strictures cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Movies cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Attack cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Puzzlement cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Breakdowns cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Triumph cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Defeat cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Hallucination cannot happen to me. I am spirit, I am free. Hallucination cannot happen to me. All right, very great. We're on the path of supernature. We are on the path of supernature here, big time. We're saying, hey, put a big heaping serving of supernature on my plate for Christmas. Thank you very much. So, at this time, let me at least say that this teaching that I'm sharing here, which is definitely firmly putting us on the path to supernature, didn't just originate with me. It came from the Holy Spirit. It came from Jesus, actually. It came from Jesus. Jesus is sponsoring, is supporting this teaching. So let us give thanks to Jesus on Christmas, who has shared the right way to pray prayer, who has shown us how to get free of this very tricky delusion of duality, right? Where we keep thinking we're making things better, but we're actually reinforcing the delusion and making the continuity problem worse, and we're all confused about what to do about it. Jesus comes along and says, I know the right way to pray. I know how to be, you can be free of this seeming trap that you're in. And I'm going to keep working with you and keep helping you and keep helping you and keep helping you until you gradually get it. So, let us be aware of this. Let us be aware of this. Let us not turn our backs just because they're dualistic interpretations of what Jesus has said. Let us not turn our backs on the singularity, teaching of singularity, of right practice, right prayer that Jesus has given us and is giving us. Because the result of this is going to be supernature for us. That's what we'll have Jesus to thank for, is supernature, getting to supernature. And we will certainly be very grateful for that. That is for sure. And of course, gratitude is due us to what we are, because we deserve supernature. This is our reality, actually. This is our inheritance. We absolutely deserve it. So gratitude is due ourselves what we are. Gratitude is due all, because that is all. All is a singularity. There's nothing that can happen to us. I am spirit, I am free. There isn't anything ever that can happen to me. And with that, we say Merry Christmas and thank you, Jesus, for helping us out, sharing your wisdom with us, sharing effectiveness with us. All right, Merry Christmas.